running this?
Yes.
Okay. Fanfarinette by Jean-Philippe Rameau, and it was arranged for two harps by Gordon Johnston. Our next two pieces are by J.S. Bach. The first one is Sheep May Safely Graze, and then a Siciliano from the flute sonata in E-flat. Sheep May Safely Graze was written in 1713 as part of a birthday celebration for Christian, Duke of Saxe-Weissenfels. It was used several times again, but not published until after Bach's death. It was written in collaboration with Solomon Franck, who wrote the lyrics, but it was never intended as a religious piece, but as a tribute to the Duke. The Siciliano is a part of the flute sonata attributed to J.S. Bach, although it may have been written in partnership with one of his sons. Probably written in the 1730s, it's been borrowed from a few flute literature by lots of different instruments, and we like it for the two harps.
Thank you.
And now for something completely different. Medical doctor Alfredo Rolando Ortiz was born in Cuba, but spent most of his life in Venezuela. Do I need the mic?
No, we can hear you.
Dr. Ortiz gave up his medical practice to devote his life to playing, composing, and arranging music for the Paraguayan harp. The habanera is a 19th century genre of Cuba, and we will now play Habanera Gris, which is arranged for two harps by Dr. Ortiz.
Thank you.
It's an adagio from one of his 12 oboe concertos. This is the one in A minor, and it's arranged for harp and organ by Daniel Burton.
So that's why we're pointing at the two harps.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. quartet, by Anton Reisa. And he was a contemporary of Beethoven. In fact, they were born the same year, and they grew up together, and they were lifelong friends. Again, I left my notes behind. Reisa wrote a lot of music for small groups of woodwinds, because at the time there wasn't a lot of that stuff around. And being a woodwind player, I played a lot of his woodwind quintets. This piece has a very strange combination. This is the original instrumentation. And we found it because during the pandemic, you know, the musicians were doing all kinds of weird things, and a lot of them weren't playing at all. And these were my friends I could get together. And I found this piece that we could actually play together, and I haven't found another piece until today, for this grouping. So we have been working on it off and on the last year, and we're finally having a chance to perform it. It is, what is the... it's a grand quartour
concertante,
yes.
And we're playing just movements 3 and 4,
yes.
Last 2 movements.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The last piece we have planned tonight, or this afternoon, is a delightful little, it's child's piece. Do you want to say some words about it?
Well, it's called Toad Pizza. And it's supposed to be a theme song for a children's book, but we haven't been able to locate the children's book.
It's not in the library.
It was written by Daniel Leo Simpson, and he's an Arizona native. He grew up here, and he went to University of Arizona and studied music, and he's a composer. And I ran across one of his pieces, and we played through it. It was a sextet, and there were some odd things in it, and I figured out what the problem was. So I contacted him, and I said, hey, we like your piece, but clarinet part has this weird thing in the middle. It doesn't fit, and I think this is what happened. So he wrote back to me, and he said, thank you very much, and he corrected the music and so forth. So we tried this one, and we were writing back and forth to each other, and he said, is there anything else that you want to know about? And I said, well, we're doing this Toad Pizza Trio thing, and the ending seems just kind of weird. And he said, well, it was originally written for orchestra, and then I made it into a trio, so yeah, the end is kind of weird. I'll rewrite it for you. So now we have it.
Did he explain the name?
No, he didn't. That'll be another email.